Welcome back on my YouTube channel. In today's video, we are going to explore the Deepness plugin. With the plugin, you can use pre-trained machine learning models. You can use them to segment your images or to detect objects in your images. The documentation also provides guidelines to train your own models. But in this video, we are going to look at the pre-trained models, and we are going to segment solar panels.
Let's go to the plugins manager, and there we look for Deepness. With plugins, it's always important to check the homepage for the documentation. So I click on homepage, and this brings me to the documentation. And there's quite some documentation, including videos provided with this plugin. What's important is to check the installation instructions. It needs some dependencies. And here I get a pop-up message that it can help me to install the dependencies for me if I click here, install packages. That takes a bit and it crashes my QGIS. After restarting QGIS, I go back to the documentation and I go to Deepness Model ZOO. This is a collection of pre-trained deep learning models in the ONNX format that is needed for this plugin. It's a good starting point to start segmenting or detecting objects. In our example, we'll use the solar PV segmentation. Let's download the file. After downloading the model, click the Deepness icon to open the Deepness panel. Expand the panel a bit so the items are readable. Check if the correct input layer is chosen. In our case, it's an aerial photograph of the area around Groningen. I zoom in on a more specific area and I make sure that processed area mask is set to visible mask. You can also choose the complete layer. Then the ONNX model that we're using is a segmenter. You can also choose one of the other options if you're doing a different type of application of machine learning, like the detection of objects. Next, you should browse to the model file, which we've downloaded. And when it loads the file, it also automatically loads the parameters, which you can see here under model info. We keep the default settings, which are also the settings that are required by the model. For example, the input channels mapping here shows 3 because we only have 3 bands, and that's also what's required by the model. But if we would have multiple bands, we can manually select which bands should be used. Then under processing parameters, you can change the resolution, centimeters per pixel, which is here set to 3. I keep the default, but you can change that. But it might be that your model is not trained on another resolution, so it's better to keep it in a first try. Some more information can be found in the documentation. So I click run, and there we go. This takes quite some time, so I'm going to do a fast forward. When the segmentation is done, you will see this pop up. It shows you the amount of area that is the background and the amount of area of the objects that you've segmented. In our case, the solar panels. It has added it as a model output group, a layer group, and we can switch off the background and only look at the solar panels. And if I change the color a bit, we can clearly see where they are. So let's make them red. And if I zoom in, I see the roofs with the solar panels, but I also see that there are some false negatives and false positives, so it's not very accurate. But if we would train this model for this specific image, we could increase the accuracy. The plugin documentation gives some guidelines on how to create these models yourself. So I'm looking forward to explore that, and I'll keep you posted in future videos. So please subscribe if you want to stay updated, and looking forward to see you next time.